everyone, what's up? Welcome to this installment of Mike's Vehicle Vlogs, and I want to thank you for joining me today, because today we're going to dismantle the heads of the Grand Am. So we're going to take the valve springs off, we're going to take the valves out, and I'm going to try to get to actually cleaning up all of this sludge and oil and stuff off of them today also. Going to be using the same method that I used when I had the Aztec engine apart, which was basically aluminum wheel and tire cleaner. That seemed to really do the trick. It didn't seem to really hurt anything with the heads because these are aluminum heads, and it really cut the grease, degreased it really well. I just took it, the cleaner, sprayed it on, let it foam up and sit for a few seconds, and then took a toothbrush, tried to scrub out all the passages, and they turned out to be really nice in the end. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do today. Gonna try not to make this video too long with this process, because I also want to take the lifters out of the engine block as well, and I want to examine the lifters, maybe see which lifter in that engine was ticking really bad. And I was told that we can probably take the lifters apart and clean them, but I don't know, I may just end up replacing lifters. So I'm trying to really move this process along, because I don't want that car to sit dismantled for a long period of time like the Aztec did. That car doesn't need a whole lot, so I'm hoping I'll have this engine put back together and the car roadworthy maybe within the next month or so. So there really shouldn't be a whole lot going on with this. This seems to be the main issue with the car. So let's take a look at these heads here real quick. You know what? We'll look at them outside. That way there's more light and whatnot. This little room in the basement's a little too dim anyway. So we'll get these heads outside. They're right in front of me on the floor. Get them outside and we'll get a good look at them. We really didn't look at the heads yet. I honestly haven't looked at the heads yet. I don't know what the condition of the valves are, what the underside of these heads look like, so this will be a first for me too. So we'll get these outside and we'll start the cleaning process. Alright, so here we go. Here's the front engine head, and this one is the back engine head. After sitting in the basement for, you know, a few days, you can just kind of see it's not looking as milky, even though it is still very milky. So we're going to clean all this up, get the valves out, the springs off. Bought my sandwich bags and whatnot to put all the valves and the keepers in, so that way they're all together and going into the proper head. So I guess the first thing I'm going to do, because I want to tip these over, I'm going to try to soak up the remaining oil that's sitting in the heads, and then that way we can look at the underside and see what the valve faces and whatnot look like. And I figured it wouldn't all come out, but it is what it is. So we'll just tip them over. We'll tip this one over first. Sit on the studs. Oh, got some white-faced valves there. Oh, I gotta pull the spark plugs. I completely forgot about that. Hopefully they will come out without breaking like the one head did in the Aztec. Okay. So, that's not too bad. I don't think that looks too bad at all, really. Let's see what this one looks like. Okay. Yeah, about the same. So we'll try to clean all that up. The sanding usually took care of the hard carbon and whatnot. So, okay. So once they're cleaned, obviously, we'll see. I'm gonna be taking these to school to actually have them checked to see if they're warped. Hopefully they're not warped.
because I really don't want to have to buy another heads or pay to have these machined. That's a couple $100 that I don't have. But get all the grease and stuff off, and then I'll do all the rest of the checking and whatnot at the school. So let's start getting the valves off, the valves and the springs and the keepers and the caps. And we'll go from there. Alright, so I'm not going to spend a whole lot of time really documenting this part, because a lot of you guys probably seen us do this with the Aztec heads. But got our valve spring compressor tool, and this is what we got to do. So we need to use the tool, you put your ratchet on it, instead of using the little tiny T-handle bar that they give you in the box. And we need to compress the spring so we can take the keepers out. And once the keepers are out, then we can, you know, uncompress it and the spring will come right off. Yeah. Probably seeing the shadow. So you can see the spring is kind of loosening. It's actually moving the valve, so it's kind of stuck to the valve a little bit. There we go. Sometimes they stick. Keep compressing that a little bit. That's about as far as that's gonna go. Oh man, the keepers just fell out. Grab one, grab the other. I've said it before, do not lose these. Do not lose these at all. They are very important. And when you put them back in, they should look like this. They bevel downward. That's also very important. We'll set that off to the side there. There's the valve, or the spring. Then you want to unarm it. Okay, so now we got our spring, here's our cap, and then the keepers. Then you can flip this up, push your valve out. So there we go, one valve's out. I'm gonna do the rest of them, and I'll get back with you guys. All of our valves and springs and keepers are out, and they're in the appropriate marked bags. You know, surprisingly enough, those valves really don't look as bad as the ones in detected. So those may clean up better. The springs themselves really weren't completely sludged over. You can still see like the metallic. Not too bad. So here's what we got without all the valves and the springs in. And we're going to get rid of these seals also. To do that, you just get some pliers, and you might need two hands, one to hold the head and whatnot. But these usually, you just kind of pull these up. Yeah, see, this one's moving. Yeah, it's hard to do with one hand because the head's moving. But you guys get the idea. You basically just pull up on this whole thing, comes off. Our new kit for the head gaskets are going to come with these seals, so we might as well, you know, get rid of them and put the new ones on. All of our valve seals are out. Those were a pain. They were really stuck on there, but look. Look at all the sludge that was all built up behind those. Especially that one. That's a nice glob right there. Ew. And then same thing with the other. Same thing with the other head here. All right, so we got those out. Those are ready to be thrown into the trash. And I have to get the spark plug socket. Train's here. We have to take these spark plugs out. And then we can start the cleaning. Start the cleaning process. Boy, I wish I had thought to take those out while these heads were still on the block. but oh well, we got them out. And you know what? They don't look all that bad. These actually look like they were replaced sometime recent. Probably whenever that engine was thrown into the car, I would think. But they are AC Delco plugs. They're not the correct ones that go into this engine. We need the 41-940. These are 41-101. Unless the part number is interchangeable. I mean, these will do, obviously. But I think the ones that are required are double platinums or platinum of some type. These might just be standard, you know, spark plugs, but they look pretty decent. All of them do, really. There's not really a, you know, anything out of the ordinary. All of them came out, so I might actually keep these. We'll see. They look good. Maybe just to save some money, run with it. If I want to change them in time, I can, because really working on that engine's not as difficult when it's in the car. It's not all too bad. So we might actually save these this time and put them back in when this car is ready. So that's it. Now comes the fun part. Gotta clean. I'm gonna try to soak up a little more of the loose oil and grime, and then we'll apply the wheel and tire cleaner. I have 3 bottles of it. This one's actually almost empty, but I ended up buying 2. They had a special on them, so I bought 2, knowing one of these bottles was probably going to be used for just these heads alone. Not a sponsor, by the way. But it works. That's all I'm saying. So, yeah, 1 bottle is probably going to be for these alone. The other bottle I can use on the cars. So, let's get to it. Tell just after our first pass, actually kind of cleaned up already pretty good. Obviously there's still a lot to do, but at least you can actually see the bare aluminum now. I'm gonna have to get a new bottle. This stuff here is pretty much done. It's time to retire my toothbrush anyway. That one there, probably not doing a whole lot anymore. Alright, so I might do one more pass with it. I know, you know, it's impossible to get all of it out, but it looks pretty dang good compared to that. So I'll probably do one more pass on the inside, and then I'll flip it over, try to do, you know, all this stuff here, and then flip it over again and do the actual head surface. But yeah, progress. Alright, so the first one is done. And this is as good as this one's going to get. The bottom here, the head surface, a lot of this is going to have to be scraped and sanded off. But, you know, for the most part, all the loose grease and sludge and stuff is off. Tried to clean up the intake ports as best as I can. That was really sludgy. It's not perfect. But it's definitely a lot better. And then, of course, our actual, you know, surface here. I don't really want to set it back down on that. I'll just carefully set it here. So that's pretty good. That's pretty good. So we're going to do that one. I'm probably not going to film any of the process with that one. And I don't know. I guess I'll go from there. But this is what we got so far. It's like deja vu all over again. Alright, so sometime later, here is head number two. Looking just like head number one. Again, this surface is the one that has to be scraped and sanded. I'm gonna go ahead and spin this around, and there's the inside. Pretty identical to the other side. Or the other head. So that's it. They're done. For now. Now, while I have this stuff out here, I'm going to go get the valve covers. And we're going to clean the valve covers up now, too. Alright, so here's what our valve covers look like after sitting for, what, a week, week and a half? Somewhere around there. I'm really surprised. Look at, I mean, all the oil and gunk is just running off, well, for the most part, running off the inside of these valve covers. So either this engine was taken care of in its former life, or somebody was here recently. Either one, you know. So I didn't use this the last time I did this. I used actual, you know, like brake clean, parts cleaner, and it didn't go so well. I used up one can, and all it did was kind of smush everything around, but these valve covers look a lot better than the ones that came on the Aztec when I got it, so this probably shouldn't take all that long. I'm going to try to, again, wipe this stuff up, and then we'll spray that, and we'll see what they look like afterwards, but yeah, they really don't look too awful. I could probably try to take that plate off and get back in there, but those, I think I tried taking one of them off on the tech, and they're like Allen or Star Bits, one of the two, and it didn't go so well. So I'm just going to leave them alone. I'll try to flush out what I can. So yeah, let's do it. would say those came out a lot better than the last time I did this. Cool. All right, so valve covers, heads, they're done. Now, as far as the sanding and whatnot, I'm gonna do that another day. I'm getting ready to call it quits. I've been in this spot forever and I'm pretty sure my neck is burnt. What time is it anyway? It is 5:45. I've been out here for about 3 hours, I think, doing this. So I'm going to clean up and call it a night. We are going to take care of the intake and the plenum stuff also soon. Along with, you know, when we sand the heads, we'll probably sand down the plenum surfaces and try to make the plenum and stuff shine. Maybe, you know, clean the back of these up again, make them shine. Maybe paint them this time. I don't know. I might paint them this time. We'll see. So that's it. I will see you guys in the next portion of this video. Alright everyone, so we're going to take a break from, you know, all of the cleaning, even though we got a lot cleaned in the earlier portion of this video, but we're going to go after the lifters now. So we're going to take the lifters out and we're going to see if we can figure out which lifter was causing the tick, if there's any you know, obvious damage or whatnot. So basically, the way to get to these lifters on this engine is there's this long cap here and there's a long cap here. We just gotta basically remove those four bolts, take those caps off, and we have access to our lifters. Each cylinder has two lifters, so here's two lifters for number two, two lifters for number four, two lifters for six, one, three, and five. The lady who owned this car before I bought it, she has been watching some of these videos, and I do believe she commented on one of the earlier videos that I had of this car and said that she believed, or may have been told or whatnot, that it was one of the number four lifters that were making the noise. So it's going to be one of these two. So when I get those two out, I'm going to look to see if there's any obvious noise or not noise, but like any obvious signs of it being a bad lifter or whatnot. And then somebody at the school said that you can usually take these apart and actually clean them out. I don't know if we can do that with these ones. These are going to be hydraulic roller lifters on this particular engine. So that's all I pretty much know from there. I also wanted to see if we can get a better look at our cam down there. You can see the cam a little bit through those holes, but not a whole lot. I did want to see if maybe we can see what the lobes look like. I thought maybe I was going to have to replace the cam, and I'm hoping that I don't have to. I really don't want to. I don't know if I'd be able to get the cam out of the engine without the engine actually being out of here, because it's going to come out this way, and even with a lot of the stuff gone over there, I don't think the engine's going to be high enough to snake it out. I think my jack fell. Yeah, it fell. I might put that mount back on too. I don't know if I like it sitting. You know, I don't know if it's bending anything on the transmission side or whatnot. Hopefully not. But, okay, enough talking. So, we need, I believe those are 10. Let me move my towel here and see if we can get a 10. That is not a 10. But this is. Train's here. Yeah, they're 10. It is also very, very crucial that we do not drop anything down into those valleys, because once they make their way in there, then they're going to fall to the bottom of the engine, or they could land on the crank. They're going to land somewhere in there. That's not good. Then that engine's going to have to come out and be opened up from the bottom. And I can't do that. I have no way of doing it here. So it's very important that we do not lose anything into any of these cavities. Let me get those covers off and we will see what we got going on. All right, so we got our four screws out. Now we should be able to take these caps off. Oh, one lifter is stuck. There we go. Okay. Make sure they all stay seated. There we go. We're going to clean these off too. We'll get the front ones off. All right. And there's the lifters. How disgusting. All right, so for the most part, they're all moving, so they're not stuck in there. Yeah, they're all moving around. So these have to go in a certain way, obviously, because they are roller lifters. There's two flat spots. One on the top, one on the bottom. So when they go back in, that's how you want them to be seated. So I guess we'll just start with this one. Should be able to grab it. Oh. Nasty. See the roller on the bottom? Probably will end up bagging these also, so we know what order. I was planning on maybe just replacing them, but if they can be cleaned and they're not too heavily damaged, maybe we can salvage them. Get this one. The lobe will hit the bottom of that roller and basically push the oil out of the top of that. That oil gets shot through the push rod that it's connected to, and the oil comes out through the rocker into the valve, valve spring area and whatnot, and it keeps the top end of the engine lubricated. So these are very important. When they are starved of oil, they'll make a tick noise because there's nothing there to lubricate these. Which is why if it is one of these that we're making the tick, they're probably plugged up with some of this nasty oil and sludge and stuff. So you can see a little bit of our cam lobe at this angle there, the lobe. Down in there. Ugh. Okay, let's see if we see anything. The damage would probably be inside. So, put this here. Too slippery. Here we go. Here we go. Alright. There's probably some scoring on there, yeah. Just from, hopefully just the age. Hopefully there's no real damage to it. And I know we can't see all of it. I'm trying to see the other side. Try to get my... might need a light for this side. Can't see anything. A little bit too dark back there. I also gotta figure out a safe way to clean this, because probably won't matter. All this stuff's gonna fall back into the engine. and probably just come out with our when we do the oil change. So I can maybe use some brake cleaner. I definitely can't use the stuff I used on the heads for this. So we might just have to try to soak all that up. Maybe spray some brake clean. Brake clean won't hurt it. And you know, it'll just come out with when we do our fresh oil after we fix everything back up. So let me go get in the house. I'm gonna get some Ziplocs for those, and we'll throw them in the bag, clean them up, and see what we got going on with those. Okay, so I wiped down all of the lifters, put them in the appropriate bags, and they're all sitting in the appropriate order inside the bags also. They all kind of look the same on the outside. They all seem to have, you know, apparent score marks. The this one here from number 5, I don't know if you can really tell in the bag, but it had a lot of discoloring from heat from the looks of it. It was the only one, I think the worst out of all of them. Looked like it had some heat discoloration. So those are the lifters. Like I said, I'll do some research on seeing if we can get them open, seeing if we can clean the insides and maybe saving them, or seeing if there's anything wrong with the insides. And now I gotta come to this. I was looking at the inside of the water jackets. Really gross in there. Looks like a film has developed inside. The camera won't focus, of course. Almost looks like a film. Oh yeah, it's still fresh in there. Stuff still moves. That's gross. Yeah, see. Ugh. I might drain the block. I can get to the passage plug here on this side. If I remove that, all of that coolant inside the block is gonna be unleashed, and that might be a good thing to get all that out of there. Can I get to the other one so easily? It should be directly on the other side. I can't really see with this stuff in the way. Oh, it's a little further down, but yeah, I found it. If I get that one out, I wonder if I can get it back in. They're kind of rusted. I might not do that today. Plus, I still have that jack under there, and I'm thinking about putting the motor mount back on for the time being. But first off, I'm going to try to get rid of the stuff here in this area for the lifters and the cam. Probably going to end up pushing a lot of that stuff back into the engine, but it's okay, because by the time we actually get to running it, we're going to drain all this out. We're going to put some clean oil in it and the good old sea foam. So the sea foam will do the rest of the cleaning that we couldn't get to, hopefully. And hopefully, I've said this before, hopefully there's no bottom end damage. Hopefully we don't have any bad bearings on the crank. Hopefully the bearings have not been chewed up by the dilution of the engine oil. So I'm just going to take the rag, I guess, and try to soak up all this stuff here, and I have a little bit of brake clean left. So I might go get another can and the good old toothbrush, and we'll just try to scrub around you know, the sludge and stuff here. I might try to do this outside also. I'm not gonna have enough to do the outside. We need like some heavy duty crap for that. So here's what we've got, and this is probably the best that I'm gonna be able to do it. I actually started to run out of the brake clean, as I expected, but I managed to get through the whole thing, and it does look a lot better. A lot of the stuff that you see there is really kind of caked on, and I don't know, maybe the sea foam might break it up in time. What I'm probably going to do once I'm done, because I'm going to try to do the cylinders now, to try to wipe down the cylinder walls and maybe the piston tops a little bit. I'm not going to use the wire wheel like I did on the Aztec, because I don't need it. We don't have any rust so far, so I just want to wipe them down. I'm gonna get some more WD-40, which is what I sprayed it in there, and WD-40 also makes a pretty decent cleaner. I already started to wipe down that one. You can see some of the carbon's coming off the piston tops, and quite honestly, I don't really care about the piston tops if they don't come out perfectly fine. I think they came out perfectly fine on the Aztec engine because we used that brush, and it just so happened to clean the entire thing while we were at it. But I'll do what I can. I don't really want to use the brush again. Plus, I don't have my drill anyway at the house. But I just want to wipe them down, maybe reapply some good oil. You know, we'll actually put some oil on the cylinder walls this time, keep them from rusting. And I'm going to dump oil into here also. You know, we're not running the engine, so I have some leftover oil that I'm just going to dump in through here. That way we could flush anything, you know, like stuff that got on the cam when I was cleaning. We'll just kind of dump it down in there, and it'll flush itself all down to the bottom of the engine, hopefully. So that's the plan so far. It's coming. It looks good. I'm not going to complain about it. I'm going to take the plastic guards in the house, and we'll give those a good cleaning also. But so far, it's not looking too bad. Some of the carbon came off. It was kind of tough to try and get some of these back ones and even the front ones, but got some of it off, wiped down, tried to get all the crust out of the, you know, cylinder walls, which is kind of tough. There's still some in there. What I need is like an air wand or something, but I don't have an air wand. But this isn't the final product because I have to sand this down anyway. So all that stuff's gonna get back in there, but I just wanted to wipe out what was in there. So what we're gonna do now is I have this quart of 530. This is from when I did the valves on the other engine, so it's never really been used. It's clean oil. And I'm gonna dump it along here, you know, in through there, just to, you know, get that stuff to, you know, flush out. And then we're going to add it to the cylinder walls also, so the walls don't rust while it still sits here. And then maybe once we do our sanding and stuff, any dirt and stuff that falls in there is going to collect on the oil, you know, on the walls, and we'll just wipe them down again and carefully wipe them down and maybe try to do a better job at, you know, getting those clean. So we'll just take this and dump it on through and try to flush any of those other garbage particles out. If I run out of this, I have that left over from the last Aztec oil change. It's a synthetic blend, but we'll just use that on the walls that's coming out anyway, you know, so. You can hear it going to the bottom of the engine. Dump some on that cam. All right, so we'll just let that sit there. I'll probably just dump this just a little bit in through here, like so. This one we might need a little more. The walls don't look too bad. This one you can kind of see because it's down so far, has some wear on it. Oh, didn't want to do that. It's okay. Good enough. And now I'll just, I guess, wipe my finger down and use my finger to kind of wipe it around. And that'll at least keep everything from rusting. Alright, so we got all the cylinder walls lubed up, and might have been a little too much after all, but that's okay. We're going to soak it up. You know, like I said, this isn't the final thing. This is just kind of preventing from, hopefully, from any of the rust to show up on the walls while it's still going to sit here for the next, you know, couple weeks. I think that's it. Like I said earlier, I'm probably going to put that mount back on now just to have it on there. We'll just take it back off. But I think for the most part, we are done out here for the time being. I got that stuff there, the lifters. Oh, the wind folded one over. So we got the lifters there. See if we can do some research on getting those apart and go from there with those. So it's amazing how, you know, we didn't do a whole lot and yet it looks better already. And it's not even, you know, near complete. So. Alright. I'll catch you guys soon.
I'm going to wrap it up now. If you guys enjoyed this vlog and want to see, you know, more of the Grand Am stuff, you know, we're making progress, so stick around. Also, give it a thumbs up, comment, subscribe. Check out teespring.com/stores/Mike's Vehicle Spotlight for all of your MVS and vlog merchandise. That's it. I will see you guys next time. I want to thank you again so much for watching. Take care.